Hi, my name is Stephen Haeg with MTS Systems Corporation. Today I'm going to spend some time talking to you about heavy truck durability testing in the laboratory. Of course, there's many different ways we can test and evaluate our products. The ultimate test is the real use by the customer in the field. But that, of course, is late and slow and not possible to control or measure or repeat. So it's very rarely used for product development. It does give us feedback on warranty costs and things and customer satisfaction, but it doesn't help us make good engineering decisions to improve our product. To do that, we usually make a reduced set of the world, often called a proving ground, where we take what we think are the most significant events that we want to evaluate for our vehicle development, and we put those onto a proving ground setting where we can repeat them and measure them and play them out in various combinations. So in the modern laboratory, we want to move that into the repetitive, measurable environment of laboratory testing and simulation. The advantage of that is that we can get engineering level quality data, we can get repeatable tests, we can see the differences in designs in real empirical data and measure directly what the results are. The repeatability in a proving ground, even though it's better than the real world, is still varied by about 5 to 1 by various studies that have been made, whereas we can get almost exact repeatability in the laboratory to see the difference in various designs and their performance. We can also take information learned in the laboratory testing and we can move it up into the analysis, the computer analysis world, the FEA and the multi-body dynamics modeling, and where we can really optimize our development capability, where we can assure ourselves that our models are right by laboratory tests. We can then test and break and view as much as we want very quickly and at a very greater savings than running anything else in the laboratory or the proving ground. That's the ideal environment to test, but when we're done, how do we know it's right? Well, then we can take it back to the laboratory and we can confirm that the system works the way the models say they do. And that's really the way a modern laboratory today is working. This kind of technology has been available in the automotive industry for about 30 years. It's been coming into the heavy truck industry for about the last 10 years or so, maybe a little longer. So it's growing there, just like it's growing everywhere else. This is an example of what I call the testing continuum. We go from fairly simple tests to much more complex tests. The simple tests are what I call comparison and evaluation type tests. We might be testing to a standard. We might be comparing two designs. Is design better? Is design A going to last more cycles than design B, for example? Or we might be characterizing, trying to figure out what properties we need to put into our computer models to get the right sort of responses. So the other side of the testing continuum is the real world simulations and real time, real channels, real velocities, real world responses. The idea being that if we design our tests properly, we'll get customer or usage correlated failures. That's exactly what we want. We want the right failure at the right place, at the right mode, and the right number of cycles. And we can do that in the laboratory. There's a lot of systems in a vehicle have to be developed. We look at our modern trucks, we've got drivetrain, engine, exhaust, steering, frame, cab, seat, suspension, hydraulics, controls, computers, software, many, many, many things in the modern truck. Each system needs to be proven safe and durable, so we've got to develop each of those systems and then work them all together as a complete product. So we often start at a fairly simple level, a material test, for example, or maybe a ball stud or a bending shaft or tension compression tests. We can test those very quickly. We can accelerate the cycle rates compared to real time, and we can test at a much higher rate. Grrr, boom. Then we're really learning something quickly. But that's not really an overall simulation of the real world. Maybe we want to move up to the component level where we're looking at motion and wear and environmental effects in a more comprehensive way of testing that component. Maybe we want to evaluate how the component works out in the system. So then we'll test that subsystem itself and focus all the testing data and the time on that specific system. Maybe we want to see how that system integrates into the full vehicle. In the case of a steering system, for example, how does it impact the instrument panel and the various firewalls and things like that are inside the vehicle?
We've just completed talking about evaluation and development approaches for heavy trucks and related equipment. There's five more videos in this series that cover about a lot of the details about heavy truck testing. The first example in video number 2 talks about steering system development, both component testing and full system testing, both durability and performance evaluation. Video 3, we talk about shaker tables. Multi-axial shaker tables are extremely common in large equipment for vibration and shock testing. Lots of stuff can't really be modeled very well when it comes to general vibration and transmissibility, so the laboratory shock tables and vibration tests are very common. Video number 4 talks about tire-coupled road simulators for off-road and on-road trucks and heavy vehicles and the advantages that they offer in quality testing in the laboratory. Video number 5 talks about suspension and chassis development tools for heavy vehicles, including components all the way through complete systems. And of course, heavy trucks take a lot of power, especially in the testing lab. And so there's ways we can adapt various technologies to apply the testing with a lower power demand and still acquire the quality of data that we need. And so we'll talk about techniques for that in video number 6, and that'll complete our series.